It was good. It was convenient. It was an egg.
Well, it's not egg.
Yeah, I know.
But I'm glad that it reminds you of that. Mm-hmm. All righty. Well, I'm going to show you how to make it. First of all, would you be willing to go to the refrigerator over there and grab me the other tofu that's in there? I wish I could say that I had 16 blocks of tofu sitting in the fridge right now, but I accidentally forgot them at home. So we do sell them, but I only have one in the refrigerator right now. Thank you so much. It's helpful to have helpers. So this is tofu that we actually pick up at the Asian market in Knoxville and bring it up here. I like it because it's non-GMO soybeans, and I like the ingredients on it. If you're in Somerset, Kroger's and Walmart both sell tofu. My favorite is the firm tofu. They make all different kinds. There's silken, there's firm, there's extra firm. Silken is basically like a pudding. It would never work for this recipe. It's really good if you wanted to make a pudding out of it. Or something really creamy that you were going to blend. But otherwise, if you're going to do something like this, you want firm or extra firm. Those are my two favorites. And when you get it, just leave it in the fridge till you're ready to use. Usually they have a decent expiration date on it. This one is October 6th, so you've got several weeks to use it. I put it in the back of my fridge, and they usually keep very well. When you're ready to use it, take it out, cut it open, and drain the water out of it and rinse the tofu off with more water. It helps just get rid of that beany water that's been sitting there for a while. And then I take my block of tofu and I actually break it into chunks. Nice little bite-sized chunks like the ones you had. And I actually do this the last thing just before I'm going to serve a meal because it tastes best immediately after it's done cooking. And it only takes less than 5 minutes to cook. So if I'm doing hash browns, I'll get them all going first. Then I'll do the ketchup, and then I'll get this going, and then breakfast is ready. Tear it off into chunks. Does everyone know what tofu is? It's made out of soybeans. And I have actually made my own tofu before. It's a lot of fun. It's a lot of work, though. But to make your own, you actually soak soybeans overnight. And then you blend them up in the blender really, really well. And then you pour it through a cheesecloth and strain out all the pieces that didn't blend. And then you pour that, what's left is basically soy milk. That's what I make soy milk. You bring that to a boil in a pot, and then you add a curdling agent, either lemon juice, Epsom salt, magnesium, there's calcium, there's a number of different things that they use to curdle it. And when you add that to that boiling soy milk, it curdles. And then you pour the curds once again through a cheesecloth, so you drain out whatever left of the water, and you put it into a mold, and you put heavy weight on it overnight in the refrigerator, and it sets up as tofu. It's really amazing. It's something that the Chinese and Asians have been doing for years and years and years, and only more relatively recently Americans have discovered the art. But it's something that's been going on for hundreds of years in other countries. So it's a great source of protein. It's also got a lot of fiber in it. So now we're just going to put the seasonings on. So what seasoning am I supposed to put on this? This is one block of tofu, so that's going to be our exact recipe.
Salt.
How much?
One teaspoon.
One teaspoon of salt? Okay. Now, I am actually measuring, believe it or not. I'm going to tell you a secret. You know how I taught myself to measure like that? I took salt and I poured it into a teaspoon. And then I sprinkled it on to see what it would look like. And eventually I learned how much a teaspoon was by sprinkling. I also learned how to measure the palm of my hand that way too, by taking a teaspoon and pouring it in the palm of my hand, and a half teaspoon, quarter teaspoon, and a tablespoon. I can measure all those in the palm of my hand if I forget my measuring spoons. So you may not think I'm measuring, but I really am, okay? Okay, what's next?
Onion powder.
Onion powder? Okay. All right, what's next?
Garlic powder.
Garlic powder? All right. How much?
Half
teaspoon. Okay, someone's paying attention. And what else?
Lemon juice.
Lemon juice. How much? One teaspoon. And yes, we're going to guess on that too. And what else?
Turmeric.
How many of you have heard of turmeric? Few of you? It's like, it's a seasoning used in curry, right? If you use too much of it, has a very strong flavor. It kind of tastes nasty. But it's an anti-inflammatory. It's really helpful for arthritis and a lot of other inflammation. And it does a really nice job at turning that tofu yellow, didn't it?
Yeah.
So that's the main reason why we're putting it in, is for color. Okay? Is that everything?
Pinch.
That was a pinch, that's right. Toasted sesame oil. Thank you. Now this is a completely optional ingredient. It is entirely for flavor. The toasted sesame oil just kind of has a nice little zing that just adds a little bit of flavor to that. And the tofu tastes good with or without it. So we're going to turn this on. And there's a spin here. And we're going to bring this tofu to a boil. And do you see what it looks like right now? It just looks like white tofu with a few yellow spots on it, right? Actually kind of brownish orange spots. When we cook this, it is going to turn it yellow while it's cooking. Turmeric does that when it starts cooking, when it hits that water and cooks. So we're going to give it just a minute here and see what it does.
Kristina, could you use the turmeric from the capsules?
Yes, you can. I don't, because it's cheaper to get it. We have it here in bulk, and you can get just a little sandwich bag for probably about 25 cents.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's more expensive.
It's more expensive to use the capsule, yes. Alrighty, we're boiling now. We're just going to stir it a little bit. Can you see? Okay. We sat in the right spot. You see how it's turning yellow? Basically, I bring it to a boil, stir it for a minute or two, and then I turn it down to medium low and just let it simmer for a couple minutes till the water evaporates. And that's it. So it's boiling nicely. I'm going to turn it down. Now look at the difference. You see that? It looks yellow now. Just from that little bit of turmeric. I didn't put much in. You just saw it. It was just a pinch. Every time I take the pot off the burner, it airs and I have to start it over. It's a smart pot plate. So any questions on what we've covered so far? Am I keeping it simple enough?
Yeah.
Oh, good. So that is going to just cook for a minute. And while it's doing that, we're going to do the ketchup. Are you ready to make ketchup? homemade ketchup. What's the first ingredient? Tomato paste. Now, notice it says 6 ounces of tomato paste. Do you know why I chose 6 ounces?
That's the size of the can.
That's the size of the can, that's right. Now, unfortunately, here at the restaurant, if we use 6 ounce cans, I'd be opening cans all day. So we get the number 10 can. So I don't actually have a 6 ounce can to
sort of say that you make your own tomato paste.
I have, but it's a lot of work.
It's a lot of tomatoes to cook it down to
Yes. Such
a small amount.
The easiest way I've found to make tomato paste is to blend up tomatoes in the blender and put it on dehydrated trays and dehydrate it and then rehydrate it into tomato paste rather than sitting there on the stove and cooking it all day. But of course, that just makes a very small amount.
Do you leave like the skins and stuff on
when
you do it that
way? If you're blending it, you
can.
Yeah,
that's much easier than having to peel all the skins off
Yes. The
other way.
The nice thing is about it, if you do it that way, you can also take it with you camping or backpacking or anything, and you've got instant tomato paste without bringing a whole can along. So we are going to guess at approximately what 6 ounces is for the demonstration. Probably a little less than a cup. All right. And then we need the same amount of water. Sabrina, I need 6 ounces of water. Any of the measuring cups should have ounces on them, but not just bring me 1 cup of water, because that's 8 ounces. So what else besides water goes in here?
Lemon juice.
Lemon juice. Okay, now you'll notice that there's some variables in this recipe. You see that? All right, 4 to 6 ounces of water, 3 to 4 tablespoons of lemon juice, 2 to 4 tablespoons of honey. The reason for the variable is because it depends on how much sweetener you want to put into it. If you put the full 4 tablespoons of honey, then you will want the full 4 tablespoons of lemon juice to counteract it.
Thank you so much.
And you will also want to decrease your water to the 4 ounces of water. Does that make sense? Because we increase the lemon juice and increase the sweetener. If you do the other way and say, I only want 2 tablespoons of honey, then do the 3 tablespoons of lemon juice and the 6 ounces of water. Am I making sense? I'm giving you tools so you can adapt the recipe the way you want. If you don't want to use any honey, you can use stevia or any other sweetener. You can also use, we're going to use sorghum molasses tonight. You can also use any kind of sweetener that you're not used to using, okay? So let's see. We're going to do the 4 tablespoons, all right? So we want 4 tablespoons of lemon juice. Now mark this, I'm measuring. Might be the only time you ever see me do it. No, I'm kidding. 3, 4. Okay, we got 4 tablespoons of lemon juice in there. And now we want the same amount of honey. I am not going to measure the honey because I will have a sticky mess on that thing. I like to use sorghum molasses. For one, it's local. It's grown right in Liberty area in Casey County. For another, it's not very processed. And for three, it's half the price of honey. They will be harvesting it coming up next month in October. It's when they harvest the sorghum cane. They grind it into juice, they run it through a boiler, and it comes out as sorghum molasses. That's all it's done to it. And you can buy it fresh from the mill, and you can even watch them do it. They don't mind. And so I like to go up there and get a whole year's supply fresh from the mill and then keep my year's supply at home. And it's a lot cheaper that way. So we are going to guess at 4 tablespoons. So what else do I need to put in here?
Onion
granules.
1.5 teaspoons.
Is granules the same as the powder?
Thank you for asking that question. No, they're different. But oftentimes when you buy onion powder in the store, it is granules that's actually in there. What we sell here in bulk is granules. The powder is actually so fine that when you open the lid, it goes poof. And if it's in humidity at all, it turns into a solid block, like within a month's time. The granules, on the other hand, you can see are a little bit more coarsely ground. They're not powder.
And the difference between that and onion salt?
Yes. I'll tell you that in just a second. The granules will not turn to a solid block in the same amount of time. Usually about a year, I can keep granules in a jar, and they'll still be granules and not rocks that I have to hit with a pick. Onion salt is actually onion powder mixed with salt.
Is that the same for like garlic salt?
Yes, it's the same for garlic. And it's the same with garlic powder versus garlic granules and garlic salt. If you buy garlic salt at Walmart, chances are it's 3/4 salt, 1/4 garlic. If you make your own, use some garlic granules. I do 50-50. 50% garlic granules, 50% salt. I make my own. But usually, instead of doing that, I usually just put garlic powder and salt in my recipe. But it is nice for a table salt. I like to do onion salt for a table, because then if someone's sprinkling on their food, they're only getting half the amount of salt, because they're getting onion powder. But if you go and buy onion powder at Aldi's, or Save a Lot, it's actually granules that's in there. So you can actually look at the bottle and tell what it is just by looking, whether it's powder or granules. Okay, so we need some garlic in here, right? About a half teaspoon. And we need some paprika.
Salt.
Oh, salt. We can't forget that. That'd be horrible. Okay.
3/4 teaspoon.
Okay, that's about 3/4 teaspoon.
Could you maybe do like an onion salt and increase the salt in the recipe?
Yeah. Actually, if you wanted to use onion salt in this recipe, you would put in, give me a second, you would put in about 2.5 teaspoons of onion salt.
So if you do
and
like
you would leave
onion
the salt out entirely.
Like garlic salt, could you maybe just get plain salt?
If you used onion salt and garlic salt, it's probably going to be too salty.
Too salty.
But you could use one of them, probably, and just increase the onion and leave out the salt entirely. Okay, so I've got the salt in there, and we got paprika in there. What else is left? Basil. Now, if you like other herbs, put other herbs in there. I've played around with oregano. I've played around with Italian seasoning. It just depends on what flavor you want. If you don't like herbs, leave them out. But for me, basil and tomato really shine. And so I love putting some basil in my ketchup. Just adds a nice flavor. Our tofu is actually done over here, so I'm going to shut it off. What do you think of it? Is that pretty? You want to take it over there and just dump it in the pot? Thank you so much. Alrighty, so everything's in here now for the ketchup, right? All I have to do is mix it up. So I just take a little whisk and mix everything up. I didn't put the water in yet. That might make a difference, right? Okay, let's put some water in there. That will make a difference. And the nice thing about the ketchup is the first day it's a little bit more runny, but the second day it gets thicker. It thickens in the refrigerator overnight. So if you make it the day before, don't worry if it's on the runny side. I actually like my ketchup a little bit runny, so it actually comes out of the bottle. But if you like it thicker, just leave some of that water out. And there it is. Here's the ketchup.
Yeah, I think she made it with her, making her own ketchup.